yourself, what keeps you trapped inside? Look at the lies that follow you when you run and hide. Look at the sky, the sun won't ask, 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 the sun won't ask.
I think we're going live. Move us down. All right, missed my cue. So we got Vex versus the Foundation or Root. I might call him either one. I'm Laser Jesus. I got awesome sauce with me today. How you thinking this match is going to go?
I'm thinking it's going to be fun. Buggy style map, Dust 2. Really excited to be here with you, Laser. It's going to be a good one. We see Ruin, Drossel, Handle, DJ, and Invert. Going up against Porky? D-Meister, Haptic, Maul, and Caboose. And this best of three. We're going to be doing Dust 2, then Cash. If needed, we'll go to Cobble. We started off right out of the gate, coming out of B. And Drossel gets up two frags. Nice for three, actually. So that's really solid for him. And it's going to shutter the defense on B. It's not a D-Meister in a 1v4. Smacked in the face at mid. It's over. Good round from Vex.
And it all came down to Drossel just decapitating three, entering into that B-bomb site. That's one of the plays where the round is most likely getting decided upon entry of the T's into the B-bomb site. A simple 4-1 play, and the Foundation had their sole player that wasn't with the rest of the squad at top mid. That's a good position if you could take the bomb site, then begin a flank, you know, divert the attentions of the CTs trying to retake into that B-bomb site. But Foundation just couldn't get the trade. I guess the next map, Cash, is one of the Foundation's stronger maps. So, might see a 2-1, who knows, but I'm definitely favoring Vex here as the long hold. Doing okay, not the greatest. They go 2-for-3, so still the advantage for the CT side, but I don't know how the bomb gets planted here.
Yeah, I mean, 3 CTs spread out. They can really just control the cross that's ruined. You know, at CT, Handled can, you know, chill at mid, and Drossel plays a back plat, and really, it's hard to get in. They do have a FAMAS coming in from Deemster, so that's good. But besides that, they do have to just be careful. You know, they don't have armor. You know, in Laser, and in a situation like this, they have to be careful. Maul might peek Drossel. He's going to get spotted out. Goes down to 30. Drossel doesn't know that, though, so I think he knows he hit him, but he just doesn't know how much damage is quite done. So now they know where the one person is, and now they got to find the other one. But yeah, they're definitely taking their time here, as I think it's probably smart to do, especially since you don't have armor to take aim duels at distance.
I try to do just a little sneaky play into the B-bomb site, maybe get the guy back of plat, but they're working silently up the catwalk, and Ruin has his eyes on mid. If Root stays silent on the catwalk, they might just be able to sneak a bomb plant. However, Vex, they've given up the bomb site. This will allow Foundation to at least get it down, but the problem comes down to post plant, because the Foundation have not taken catwalk, they don't have control long, and they're going to get split from both catwalk, long, and maybe even the CT spawn at the same time. I don't see how they come out on top of this one. D-Meister going to have to come up huge. Has a lot of HP, but doesn't have enough bullets left in the clip. He's got to reload. He has one left in the chamber. I don't think he realized it. But Vex are going to take another one. Very expensive, though.
Yeah, very expensive, and they get the bomb down. I mean, that's huge, right? I mean, in that situation, you're in a 2v3, you don't have armor, and you end up making it work. You do get the bomb down, three players died, and yeah, I mean, it's not a horrible situation for them to be in, and now they can buy. I would assume they are going to buy unless they want to, you know, maybe, you know, buy some pistols and try to make it work, but they're going to go ahead and buy. Porky starting it out there, and, you know, Foundation again, a good round for them, Laser, and I'm curious to see how they're going to take their... They're good round, not a great round, but they're good round into the next.
Yeah, with these AKs, I mean, they do have the advantage just with firepower. I mean, it's not like Vex has any SMGs or shoddy scout on board, anything like that. So, full first rifle round. But this will be an advantageous one, as stated, for the Foundation. They're opening up slowly, getting mid control, making sure nobody's pushing the catwalk. And see how aggressive they get out mid. Just doing a little probing here, Mal and Porky. Both just seeing if anybody's peeking either side of mid. But with the position of the other players, one inside of the B tunnels and one outside of long, we'll see how quickly they could shift this into a commitment, and they are going to commit onto B.
Yeah, and as it's probably the best move for them to do that, here they go. They're going to try to get in. Drossel getting a frag. But look at this Foundation doing some good work there, getting the frags on B site and cutting off that mid player. And now Vex probably would save here unless they get a quick pick initially. But they're not really in a great situation to retake. On the B site, even in a 3v3, it's hard to retake it. So,
yeah.
He's going to have to fight him, too, and he goes down. So, yeah, now you got to try to save that FAMAS. And B site's a hard site to retake, Laser, as you already know. So,
I was wondering, I mean, maybe in the 2-on-4, if Vex go for it, at least go for some exits, because where we're going to be at in the next round, now that the Foundation have survived with 4, it kind of takes the 4-spy out of the equation for Vex. Maybe if one more kill is applied after DJ takes out Porky, you could argue for a 4-spy, especially since the AK is on board. So this is an interesting decision that Vex is faced with, because the Foundation's economy will go pretty low. I mean, two players will definitely not be able to buy if the Foundation loses one. We'll see what the decision is.
Yeah, a decision needs to be made now, yeah, for sure. But, you know, hey, this kind of a map really kind of lends teams to doing whatever they want. You know, they get a long spawn, they get to work to long. You know, they get a B spawn, they can do a B train. Or if they just want to play it slow, they can as well. And it's sometimes predicated on that mid pick. We're not seeing that this round. But we are seeing DJ hanging out outside along, trying to make sure nobody pushes in. Matisse taking a part of lower tunnels and trying to see if anybody's going to make a mistake and push out, as DJ's the only one that has armor AK for Vex, Laser. And they just have to take a step back and look at the big picture here if they're the Foundation to figure this out. Because if they misread this, they could walk into that B stack.
And the mid to B was successful prior. Maybe additional feel of safety towards that B bomb site. Just to touch on the economy one more time, I thought Vex might go for the 4-spy as well, because now they have to double save. If they're planning on saving at all in this one, it's going to have to be a double, because next round they still won't have that great of potential to buy equipment. The Foundation, like you said, working it out, figuring where the CTs may be, and there's a big pick as Maul will find DJ at long. If he pushes any further into long, Foundation will realize that this is a full B-side stack, and that was the rifle taken away. So now Vex, best option is just to try to strip away some weapons.
Yeah, and it looks like they're going to try to do that by going to T-spawn, trying to prevent people coming out long, at least it appears like it at this point. But yeah, I mean, you're right. Once DJ went down, they really knew nothing was going to happen. And so now they're going to try to do some work with these USPs and P250 on Drossel. And some of you probably know who Drossel is. Here comes Mal, though. It's a quick frag. Oh, nice shot by Drossel, as I was just talking about him. And he's going to get one. He's going to have to try to go out to mid, and he does hear some noise. He's going to get pinched. He goes down. So Foundation, two all now, and they've got to be happy with coming back into this and not letting the pistol round win put them in too much of a hole at this point.
An interesting thing about Invert, Drossel, and Handled, I mean, they've all played together previously. And Invert never seemed to be the same Opper as he was on the old Lunatic, I believe it was, and when they had that core group where he was really beginning to shine and getting noticed and everything. And I've always thought maybe if he was playing with some of his former teammates, maybe he'd have that standout performance like he did. It was a lower-tier league, I think one less than Premier, that he was doing so well. So maybe that's it. But we'll see Foundation taken to the B-bomb site. So far, none for Vex. Invert manages to run through the window and just gun down Caboose. Root kind of struggling to avoid that frag, but that'll be three for the Foundation. And now, finally, we'll see the next gun round out from Vex. And since they went with the double, it'll be a full buy.
Yeah, good round by Foundation. You know, and look at their money, too, Laser. I mean, real solid for them. Porky, you know, he's got $7,600. You know, if they run into, you know, a little bit of some trouble, they're not going to get reset if they lose one round. So, hey, you know, that's good for them. They have to feel confident about that as they did drop the pistol. They are going to kind of reset here and maybe throw, looks like an Xbox smoke from Porky. And looks like they may try to move up from Cat.
This might be quick.
Cat, excuse me. Yeah, that's kind of what it seems like. You know, they got Caboose coming in here. They're throwing a lot of utilities at Cat to try to make noise. And you know, Cat's one of those positions, Laser, as you know, if you can get Cat control, which a lot of the time on Dust 2 CTs will give it up, you can get Cat control, you can do a lot of good stuff on the A site, and you can do fakes, and you can go back and try to do a B split if you smoke CT. There's a lot of good stuff they're doing, but right now, they're not going to do that. Invert's going to fight Deemster, he's going to go down. So Invert does get the frag, and here comes four of them. They're going to just rush out on Cat.
Handled, though. He's able to get one from Carr and then falls back towards Long. Might have to watch his back as the Foundation is taking into the bomb site. Invert peeks from the CT spawn. May be unnecessary because the rest of the retake was not there yet. Now Vex will know for certain that it is the A bomb site play. And at least the Foundation this time have control of the catwalk. They have to hang on to it. One of the problems they're facing, though, is Vex. The B players are going to be armed with pretty much full utility as they didn't have to use much so far. The Foundation, can they hang on to the catwalk? One of them has been dropped. It's Mal from the bombsite. Porky, he's too far away from his teammate. He can't support. The rest of the CTs have already been allowed up towards the rail. And now it's just Mal in a 1v2, and he can't stay alive. Vex takes a critical round, but this next one equally is critical.
Nice job for them, yeah. You know, they weren't able to hold the cat control like you noted earlier. And they are going to drop this round, but they're not going to get reset. And that's really the most important thing here is that, you know, sometimes losing something like that, after you win a few rounds, you can get reset depending on how many people were alive. You know, they did have, you know, they had three or four surviving on all of those rounds that they had won. So they're in a good spot here, and this is not going to break their economy. Vex, I don't know if they're going to read well into this or not, but it doesn't matter because they have an op, an AK, and some M4s to try to deal with this. But it looks like a B-train coming in from Foundation very quick. Here comes Caboose.
I think it was staggered by the Molly. Caboose, he just wanted to run right in there, but the rest of the squad were kind of hanging back. That did allow at least two kills to come up from Vex, but there's D. He's a top mid, looking like the pistol round strat from the Foundation. I think it was D a top mid previously. But now Vex will come for the 2-on-3 retake, or will they? This is another spot where I wouldn't mind them going for it, because getting reset here is another double save situation for them.
Valid points that you've made there, but I don't know if they're going to go for it. Yeah, they're going to go ahead and save. So Vex is going to fall back and save. So good job from Foundation. And yes, you're right. Vex need these people to survive. They need to have some sort of defense, at least put maybe one or two people on a site and hope that the other team picks, Foundation picks the wrong one. But they're going to be challenged here coming up along. Let's see what he does.
He's going to fall to DJ. And with these kills now coming, since they've killed three, that might mean we get the force buyout from Vex, especially since Handled and DJ both have AWPs. See what the decision is. It's not a whole bunch for the rest of the players to force buy with. Looks like they have eked out a M4, so maybe just one person lacking a weapon here. Okay, it is going to be two. So very important round. The Foundation's money might finally get broken. And Vex, they're still not out of dodge. They still have to win these rounds to avoid getting reset themselves.
Valid points that you said there as well. Deemster, though, they don't want to have any more issues. They want to get in here and they want to keep this going. You know, they won the three, they dropped the one, and you're right. They don't want to get reset, which very well could happen. Val's just going to go ahead and go up there. Haptic, nice frag. Mid-presence is very well there, and they're going to get it done, and they're going to do this B-split. They've got him isolated in the site, but that's handled again. Another frag for him. And now it's a 3v2 situation, and I think Caboose is now in a 1v2. He could do this. He does have to get the bomb, though. And they've got an op, an M4 coming aggressively at him. Caboose playing passive, trying to see what they're going to do. Waste utilities. This is smart. He's waiting for them to throw a lot of stuff over utility-wise. If some of you that are wondering at home, why is he not just trying to smoke it and make it work or flash it? He's trying to see if somebody's going to make a mistake. And Invert, you know, is not clearly doing that at this point, Laser. And they don't want, you know, their money situation to stay low. They want to make this work. They're in a position to do it. But let's see if Caboose gives it to him.
After about 20 or 30 seconds, another player has to think about rotating from the CTs in that spot. So I think that's why Caboose waited all that time. But he goes down trying to cross into the bomb site. Anyways, a big pickup there by Vex. And the Foundation still might not be done buying. They could definitely go either way with it. But I like the attempt by Caboose because, as you're saying, not going in right away. You allow some doubt to go into your opposition's mind that you might not be at that bomb site. After so much time has elapsed, you have to maybe rotate another player off. Looks like the force buy had been called for the Foundation. Neither team able to really get a firm grasp on their economy so far this game. Very tight-knit match on Dust2. But not a bad buyout from the Foundation. Don't have all that great of utility. They're beginning to work up towards the catwalk. Another play by Vex where they've pretty much given the catwalk up, but Invert might think about going for a peek. You know, I'm not a big fan of the setup right now from Vex at this A bomb site. They don't really have control of cat, and they don't really have control along. I mean, handled is shifting back and forth, but a very delicate setup onto A, which you're forcing both of your individual players to win potentially a one-on-two and come out alive, because the two Vex players can't support themselves that well. If the split is called from the Foundation, there's the entry.
Yeah, it does. It does put you in a bad situation for Vex to nod the positioning wise. You're right. It puts him in a bad spot, and they open it up with a boost. There's DJ though with a nice op shot. That was nice. So it's going to be a 3v3 retake situation here. Fire coming out from sight, and so now Haptic's going to drop down, go for the spray. Not going to work. Ruin takes him out, and now it's a 3v2 situation. Ruin, Drossel, and DJ trying to get in here, trying to make this thing work here. The bomb looks like it is planted for Cat. Deemster, a nice frag as well. Coming in here. Oh, DJ, a nice USP shot. He's going to go ahead and stick this. Is he going to get it? He does.
Oh, it's going to be close.
And it's going to be close, and he gets it. So he is going to find a way to make it work. 9 health on Maul. But a good job there from Vex to get that in there, get that defuse, and stick it. Even though he did have his teammate die, he was able to get it done because of the positioning of the bomb. If they want to plant it for long, you know, potentially it's a different story, but a good job by them.
So low with the economy. Still both teams, nobody over 1,000 except Invert. And what a play made in the end just to stick that bomb, and enough of a distraction made for the diffuser that he's able to make that play in critical point in the match. Again, the economy so low. The Foundation, they like what they've seen at B, and wow, they trade out favorably. 2-for-1, Drossel and Ruin, and there's D. He's came alive at mid whenever the Foundation have taken into this B bomb site. Oh, how'd he die? He burned himself. He mollied the window, and the fire just, like, started his hair on fire.
I was like, wait, what? I was like, what happened? Yeah, but that's unfortunate. So now 2v2 situation, definitely doable on the B site, but you got to get in there quickly and make this work. DJ looks like he's going to fight Porky. Porky gets rocked, and now it's down to Maul here in a 1v2. He's going to go for that spray. Not going to work. So a nice job by Vex getting it done. Unfortunate that Caboose kills himself with a fire, but it is what it is. Vex 6-4 at this point.
It's one of those interesting mechanics of the game where the fire will, like, creep down, or I don't know. I don't understand how the physics of the fire work, but hey, Caboose killed himself. But he died while planting the bomb, so I'm not sure how low he was, but he might have had time to get out of there, or he just really wanted the plant. I'm not sure which one it was, Finally, the Roots money has been broken, and they're going to have to secede and save, probably begrudgingly, as it's been quite some time since they've had to come with this sort of buy. In another spot, this seems to be one of their go-to setups, where they have four people towards B and then have D lurk about at mid. This time, I don't think it'll be as impactful with D at mid, because the entry fragging power isn't necessarily there this round for the Foundation. At least less so than it would be with AKs. But they're going to bust out with a hard mid to B, but they have the bomb inside a tunnel, so he's going to have to find good timing.
Oh, and Haptic, they're caught with his knife out, gets rocked. They're outside of CT, and they're just running around with these Tech Nines, just trying to see if they can do anything. They try to do a mid-B split, but Ruin doing some damage as well. Last person alive goes down. Drossel gets him 7-4 scoreline, and yeah, it just seemed like they put two smokes at CT. A little bit of miscommunication there, maybe. So they throw two smokes. They come out. Haptic's got his knife out, peeking towards B site. Sees two enemies, goes down, and they just all fell apart from there.
Yeah, maybe a bit off with the two smokes. Maybe they're just trying to ensure that they couldn't get fragged from the jump up spots. Ruin gets tagged on the cross. So a little more tender at that B bomb site. And the Foundation have proven that they could just rush into B. And when they've done that, they've came through two people. I mean, sometimes if you have a read that your opponent is playing only one at B, you'll go with the hard plays and just try to trade out onto the one player there. But the fact they're able to run through two, I think Vex is going to be playing two at B for the rest of the game. Or at least on what shortly is left of the CT side here. But this time, the Foundation have been allowed out long. This time, three players actually at the bomb site, though. They don't have, you know, two split off and one in the CT. So a little stronger hold, but still very individual. You're forcing these players to come out of the one versus one alive. As it's two for one so far, Vex holding okay, but it wasn't a hard commitment yet by the Foundation onto A, which they will do now.
And they're doing that and falling out, actually. Haptic, a nice frag there at long, so they did force Handle to kind of get aggressive and try to get some information, and that feeds him a frag. DJ and Ruin for these CTs down to low health. Doesn't matter, though. As he picks up Haptic there. Oh, Porky double spray down. That's going to make it a little bit easier, but Drossel, full HP. Does have this A1S, so it's not a one-hit headshot, but could hit some good sprays depending on how he comes through the smoke or if he waits. That's the question, because Maul waiting right outside of that smoke. He is going to go for it, but he's going to get taken out. Good round by Foundation, though, to come out long, show a little bit of commitment, fall out, and give him the chance to hit that op shot on the Handle. Handle got a little bit too, maybe eager, and goes down. So, good round by Foundation.
It's a risky play by Handle, but it does have its merits. If he's able to push up and clear out long, and maybe he even wins that duel versus Haptic, and then it's a one versus one with the remaining player at long. But if he does push up long and clear it, that's a ton of intel for Vex. Unfortunately, he's dropped by Haptic. And then very nice timing by Porky to come up and drop the two players trying to boost up Elevator. Vex might be regretting that, but it's Ruin with the op, interestingly enough, towards the B side. Maybe predicting that Foundation was going to go for that hard B play once more, but them just trying to feel it out allows Ruin to get the shot off onto Caboose. And now the rest of the Roots are just chilling outside of the A-bomb site. I think they will commit onto A eventually here. But a good setup by Vex this time. It looks a lot stronger than their previous couple. As they doubled up on the catwalk, they got Invert watching long. Not with the op, but the Famas. And shot missed by Haptic, it seems, towards long. And that was a vital one, because now Invert, he's probably not going to peek long again after seeing that op.
No, and there's really no reason to. Yeah, and I do agree. Having this situation is better, because having somebody in Purgatory kind of covering long and kind of covering cat's a bad spot. Now Maul knows what's going on.
What's
he's
going to
go and smoke it. Well, you know, he's... I'll explain after the round. Comes
okay.
In here, goes down. So
there
basically, what I meant by that is, for everybody, so you pointed out a few rounds ago that when they were having a weak setup on A, they had one at Goose, one on Cat, and then they had one kind of in between Car and Long, and they didn't really have him dedicated covering Long when you talked about that being weak. And I think doing the two Cat and one towards, like, back part of ramp, you know, A ramp or Goose is a better play. And I was just basically agreeing with you on that and saying you put yourself in kind of in the middle ground situation where you can't fully commit to one position, you know, because that person
along. Okay, so you're referencing Purgatory. Now, I thought you meant it as it was a position on the map or something.
Oh, no. Oh, that's hilarious.
It's like, I've heard these new school calls, but I haven't heard that one yet.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Foundation here, armor, some pistols. A lot of damage done to him, though, from that mid player that was inverted. He did get one. And now they're going to flood up cap. But yeah, Laser, definitely a little bit of confusion. Sorry about that. But that was funny that you thought that. So here they go. They're going to try to get out. Can they do it?
Handled. We'll get the first one. It looks like they're willing to trade the bomb site for a better shot at winning the round. I don't know if that's the right play, though, because, I mean, Vex just might have been able to end it right there, but they fall back. Maybe worrying about long as Handle does fall back all the way into the doors. Probably too passive here, as now another player gets picked off from Vex, and the retake hasn't really even begun. As Handle now just coming up the long, he does have his teammate coming up from the CT. Ooh, Mal, he gets caught out. And Handle taking more and more real estate up long. D, unaware that Handle was boosted up long, but here at what is now called Gandalf for some reason. Haptic. And no deal. That's going to be Vex with 9. And just touch on another one. You're talking about having that player in a purgatory, as you referenced it. A lot of that boils down to like how the map is developing. If, you know, like the Foundation have shown that they can bust into B in a 4-on-2 and trade off favorably, maybe that makes Vex think, you know, we can't really, maybe we have to dedicate that player into CT spawn and only play 2 on the A bomb site. So it's just kind of how the map goes based upon what the T side strength is that can dictate what setups the CT side are going to go with more often, I think.
Yeah, good point. Good point. Yeah, I don't know. To me, I'm either kind of an all-in or a not-in person, you know? And so when I see that, I'm kind of like, I don't know. But, hey, these guys know what they're doing. And DJ's going to go ahead and find a frag here at long. It's going to start things off really well. So it's that team flash coming out. Good job from him. Now Winvert's going to have a little bit of a Deemster on his hands here. But Drossel comes in and actually helps out at mid, and that's huge. And puts him in a 5v3. Now they could just play back and hopefully be able to trade these T's out and shut them down if they're going to try to work up cat. You know, it seems like they only got a one-pronged attack. They do have a few utilities. They do have a Molotov and a smoke. 3 smokes and a couple flashes. We'll see what they try to do with it.
That's probably the round ended right then and there. If Handle hits that first shot, and that's pretty much the end. I mean, 2-on-5 from that, no chance. They needed that entry, and from there, it might have been doable, but 10-5 our score. And it was close, very close at the beginning, but then Vex just seemed to pull away a bit in the end. And they won pistol, so, I mean, if Foundation takes that, we probably have an even half here. But Vex, I think, proving that they are the better team, at least thus far. Maybe the Foundation has a 6 CT side, but quite unfamiliar with most of the guys on the Foundation, very familiar with most of the guys on Vex. So, just bias due to how many times I've seen them. But the Foundation, this isn't a stomping by any means. This could have been a close half.
It could have. I mean, Foundation, you know, really not having necessarily the best T side. But they did okay. You know, it's not going to be impossible for them to come back into this. We'll have to see how they play this pistol round, depending on how Vex does. But they're going to actually play this aggressive at mid.
Wow.
Send 3 people to fall up there, and now they're going to fall back. So now they get a little bit of intel, but they give it up. And it looks like they maybe have this anchor. Yeah, this anchoring set up here on either side. And then they just have the 3 people just running around together.
So they show themselves mid. They wanted to announce their presence and then immediately fall off and do something different. But the problem is Vex didn't even have anybody spotting mid for the majority of that. So the Foundation make a bunch of noise at mid, fall back towards catwalk, hoping that maybe Vex will make a quick move based upon what the CTs have shown them. But it seems like it's working out so far, as Invert will fall towards the A bomb site one more. But oh no, there's the pick Vex was looking for. That changes the round entirely. Now it's a race to the B bomb site, and the Foundation, they're quick on the flank towards tunnels.
Yeah, this could be doable here. It's just going to depend on how they get in and get these frags. But Forky starting off well with 2. And Caboose comes in with 1. It's all down to Ruin. And guess what? He's outside of the site.
Okay.
The fuse is happening. Haptic running out of time here. He's going to have to continue to stay on this. But it doesn't matter. Caboose gets the frag. So they're going to win the round. But wow, that was definitely an interesting setup by Foundation. 3 down mid. They fall back. Do a boost up cast. They kind of hang out in the middle. Just chill. And then they're able to rotate together. It did work, though.
Yeah, it ended up working. But I don't think that was due to what they showed Vex at the beginning. It was kind of inconsequential, but a very aggressive play. But the way Vex was opening up, how tentative they were at not peeking mid, it kind of didn't matter in the end. But it was an interesting setup nonetheless from the Foundation. That's what I like to see. I like to see that creativity on the pistol rounds. And a lot of CT side teams will just rely on that distance with the USP. But oh man, this is going to get messy on the catwalk. Caboose has them lined up and they're just going to get wrecked. No eco kills allowed. And just a firm hold.
Yep, wrecked. So that's all there is to say about that. Just to clarify everybody for the map picks, so everybody knows, I just want to go over this again. Dust 2 was Vex pick. Okay, Foundation pick, Cash, random was Cobble. So we might go to Cobble. We don't know. We got Dust 2, Cash, and then Cobblestone. But yeah, so pretty much a standard round for Foundation here. 7-10 the score line. They went pissed around, and all of a sudden they're back into this now, but handled. Getting Maul on the cross. Got to be upsetting for him, but it's not the end of the world. You can play a 4v5 as a CT, but I don't think they were expecting, at least it looks like with their buy, they weren't expecting, you know, AKs and op, and an op. And that's kind of questionable because you know that they're going to buy. So
if the question is, do you want to guarantee this momentum that you have by buying up fully? In which case, if you lose that round, then you're facing a reset. Whereas if they lose this one, they'll still have an okay buy following. So that's kind of what you're juggling in that situation. But of course, that gives a round to the T side where they're going to have a better chance of winning based upon them having the big guns out, namely handled already having the op on round 3 despite losing the first two. So nice money management. Not sure if it was planned, but hey, he'll take a glass cannon any day of the week if I know the guy. And the Foundation, they're still not out of this, but again, it's that lack of weaponry or the deficit that they're facing, and got to hit nasty shots with the scouts if you're going to make them useful.
Oh, yeah.
He's in the back of the B plat, and this could be the difference maker. Not handled too fast.
Well, to me, Laser, you know, the reason why I brought that up, you know, about that buy not being as heavy as I figured it would be is because, you know, you won the pistol, you were down 5-10, now you're 7-10. You might as well just do everything you can in this round to make sure that you have the best chance to win it. Because if you do, you put the T's in a bad spot, but instead they lose that round. And now Vex is 11-7. If Foundation loses this round, they're on an eco. And so now it could potentially be 12-7, depending on how this plays out. It looks like it's going to start played out long, though. Is there going to be a 3v3 at long? Handled gets a first frag onto Maul, but gets traded. There should be a quick refrag comes in. And they're going to get long control here. So they do get long control. Now they can fall back off of this, maybe run some sort of a fake. Looks like that's what they're going to do, but unfortunately, Ruin goes down at mid. And here they go. They're just all three. Going to push up long, and there comes the battle. Invert goes to the spray. Gets one. It's all down to Deemster in a 1v2 with a FAMAS. He's going to go get this AK. Yes, he is. And he's going to have to retake on cat or save or go to long. It just depends on what he wants to do, but this is not a good situation for him to be in.
Did he hear Handled move to pit? I think he did. He's going to flash up cat if he can win this duel with Handled. Sure, he'll make it a one-on-one, but he still has no HP. How's he going to approach? He's worried that Drossel might come assist Handle that long, but Handle not going to miss. And he's been playing really well coming into the later part of this game, finding entries on both of these important rounds previous where he got the cross pick on Damal, and then he gets an opener at long. And now the Foundation, they're going to have to save. So the situation we keep talking about, like, should the Foundation have gone for a full buy in round number 3, or was it worth it for them? Could it have been worth it for them to save up the guns? And if they win that round, well, then they're way far ahead. So it's one of those spots where there's no real wrong answer,
right?
Just depending on what you want to do, what you're trying to accomplish with what the score is currently. But right now, it doesn't seem like it's panning out for the Foundation, but they've gone aggressively out mid, and that's one. If they can get another, they could definitely do this round.
Oh, and another frag there by Porky. That's good, but he's going to get refrag. That's an unfortunate handle, getting a frag as well, so they know they're unlimited money here. And so they do end up getting it even, at least on players. But oh, look at this Deemster, nice frag by him. He stays back there, waits, ends up peeking up and getting Drossel. And so now Deemster here could potentially do so much damage, but goes down to the op. And now they're going to have to retake in a 2v2. They're going to smoke the cross and double flash over. That was kind of funny to see. Here it comes. And are they going to just run straight through the smoke? Invert actually taps the plant here, Laser. Didn't stick it, and they win the round. Foundation comes in with a huge round of their own.
This next round is so vital for the Foundation. If they lose this one, that's probably the game right then and there. So, Vex, I do think they will go for the buy. Might be lacking a bit here and there, but this next round is so, so big for the Foundation. If they win it, well, that's 9, probably moving up to 11 because Vex looking at a double save if they can't get the bomb down. So this is everything for our CT side, and they've gone with a 3-1-1, something we didn't see Vex do very often, maybe due to Foundation's strong B trading ability. Vex is opening up with a nice spread default style, and giving Handle time to work is something that I think they'll find success with too, based upon his current form. Speaking like he's like an anime character or something, but Ruin comes out mid, and that he'll bring down D, and I think he just straight ran through his smoke. Wow, D had an op and everything, so now Vex, they're gonna step on the gas and just bust out mid.
And they're trying to make this work, but they do get shut down a little bit. Now they're gonna work their way up under to upper tunnels now. And they do have a lot of these CTs over on this side of the map. You gotta be curious now, all three of them in upper tunnels. Is somebody gonna attempt to flank? But since the CTs are up in a 4v3 laser, it appears that they are not going to do it. They are going to fight, and good shot by Handled. You're right, he is coming alive right now. Jumping off attempt by Haptic. He didn't hit it, though. So now they're going to have to play just outside of the site in a 3v3, and the question is, do they let him plant, or do they try to prevent it? That's the question here. Drossel, oh, it's
wow.
Over. Vex gets it done. Three quick frags at the end, and yeah, WoW says it all.
Just like that. The B bomb site, we always talk about how difficult it is to retake, because that can happen, and it does happen often. If there's a smoke or Molly that goes down, I mean, with the addition of incendiaries and Mollies now, the retaking ability of the B bomb site just decreases dramatically. There's smokes, Mollies you have to jump through, at least the Foundation all went at the same time, but that's how fast your chances can evaporate in Counter-Strike. In the blink of an eye, you go for the retake, and now you're looking at potentially a double save. We see D dropping down to 750. Now the money's all spread out, so that's getting ugly as well. It's just so fast that things can fall apart in this game.
Yeah, you know what? I think that's one of the beauties. You know, that's one of the beauties of Counter-Strike is that, you know, it's such a momentum-based game, but it can be shattered in one round. But we're going to see a little bit of a move here by Porky. He wants to try to hold long and see if he can make this work. But he does have five Ts around him, and he's not aware of it quite yet, but he might be hearing a few of them moving around. I think actually if you can get some information, potentially the CTs can do some damage. I don't think they'd be able to do too much. There's DJ gets the frag on the Porky. Mal and Deemster here just trying to get something out of this round right now, and it should be 14-8 once it's all said and done, barring something insane. And I just don't think that's going to happen at this point, but there it is. There's one frag. Now he's going to have to pull the knife out. Nope, not going to happen, so 14-8 the scoreline, and yeah, you're right. I mean, that was such an important round, and now they're in a bad situation. Foundation, now, you know, you could buy now if you want, or you can play for the tie.
And
I'm going to go ahead and buy now.
They should have, I mean, saved. If they're planning on buying this round, you save everything in the last round for this round. And we saw, I think it was D go down solo. Like, I think some of the lesser teams, like, you have to have super diligence in these situations to maximize your chances of winning the important round, which is this one. And now a couple of the players are lacking because they bought up in the previous one when the rest of the teammates didn't. You have to stabilize that economy. Either the strat caller has to have an iron fist, or I guess you just need more diligence with your money. But some players want to have a chance to get a kill so badly on the rounds that aren't as consequential.
Yeah, and it's hard because you want to do everything you can to help your team out, but sometimes helping that your team out means you just don't buy anything and you think about the next round. And I could see sometimes how, you know, you get a little bit in, you know, frustrated, like, oh, you know, if I had a P250, and then maybe the next time you buy a P250 anyways. But here's Invert there, fighting it long. Actually, nice frag, the first frag, but he's going to get traded out by Caboose. That's a good frag by him, so the long push slowed down a little bit, but DJ trading in and getting some more stuff done over at upper tunnels. And the T's are in a good position here in a 4v3. They do have a decent amount of map control except long, but the CTs are going to get aggressive here because they're trying to make up for it. And no, Ruin gets a frag on him.
That was unbelievable. The guy jumps off of catwalk, fading away as whoever was working up catwalk is creeping up, and this game gives him the jumping, falling two tap with the Galil, like back-to-back headshots. Like, I don't understand. And it's just so unfortunate for the Foundation on a round where they can't lose that happens. That's just where you throw your hands up in the air and say, well, there's nothing I could do better in that situation.
Yeah, and it's frustrating for sure. I mean, you've got to be really upset about that. But Foundation looking to come back into this, looking to tie it up. Down 7. They need 7 in a row to tie it up and put this thing into overtime. And they're going to be hard-pressed to do it. They do have a couple good pistols here that they'll be able to use, but The three stack on B site from them. Here comes Vex. They're going to come out, but Deemster, two quick frags with a 5-7. He's going to put a little bit of a damper on this aggressive push. Can he do more with it? He cannot, unfortunately, for him. And so now it's down to a 3v2 situation. Porky and Caboose, with one of them with the Deeg shot. Actually, that's Porky doing so much damage, gets another. And now it's Invert here to try to save it, but he does spot one. Now Invert is spotted, knows where. Caboose knows where he is, and now he has to hit him. This is Caboose to save and continue on in this map. Invert wanting to end this now. They're both aggressive here, but who's going to get the best of him? That's the question. Caboose gets him, and we're playing more CS on Dust 2.
That was very tricky by Caboose, and Invert maybe getting a little too fancy. He might have thought that Caboose was inside of the site or had made his way out of double doors. There's a lot of mind games happening right there because Caboose definitely had time to make it into the bomb site if he wanted to go find a weapon instead of just maintaining the 5-7. And then Invert decides to get fancy by dropping the smoke right outside of the doors, giving Caboose access if he was close to that flank. So very nicely done by Caboose, but there's handled again. He's just always getting these entry kills, and this time it's toward the B bomb site. When you're playing a 3-1-1 and you lose that B player, the shift is instant. You have to shift your setup instantaneously, and that's what we see from the foundation as they instantly go 2-1-1.
The Vexer wanted to close this thing out right now. They don't want to be in a bad situation economically, because if they lose this round, they're going to have to battle up and save. Depending on if they get the bomb plant, of course, that could help them a little bit, but Vex wants to end it now, and they do have a good start with that first frag. And they just have to be patient and see if the CTs are going to make a mistake. They got a minute left, so they can just chill, see what's going to work out. And then they're going to kind of collect up and try an A split or a B split. I would assume they're going to try some kind of a move onto A and off Cat, and maybe work off of that and force somebody to make a mistake. Let's see what that's going to actually do here. No, Porky gets a frag at least. He's going to get one, but gets traded out by DJ that was already in CT. They can do some stuff, and then Haptic with a shot through the smoke is going to even things up in a 3v3. Chaos ensuing on the B side. They're going to get in there with DJ spotting Haptic, so they know where he is. They're going to plant. And here comes the retake from Haptic and Caboose. Not in the best spots, though. They're going to have to come from the door. They just jump right in there, throw flashes. Haptic not hitting any shots. And it's 16-9. That's your scoreline in this first map. It's over.
Yeah, it just came down to Haptic there. He had his chance onto the player coming out window, but the pop flash was good. That kind of stuttered his ability to get some shots off right away. So there it is. Vex taking it on Dust 2. But the foundation definitely showed that they can game with Vex. It's not like there's an outstanding difference in the aim department or anything like that. And this is, I think a lot of it had to do with Handled on that T side, just getting a bunch of entries with the AWP as well. But on to Cash, and I've heard good things about the foundation on Cash. Third will be Cobble if necessary, but I don't think it's necessarily a guaranteed win for the foundation by any means on Cash. But I do want to direct everybody over to skinsanity.gg, a new sponsor of ours, and a very interesting concept, something new and fresh into the CS betting, or not so much betting here, but it's kind of like Quibbits, if you know what that is, where you get some GG points either by, I mean, there's a couple different methods in which you can get your money in there. I mean, there's G2A pay, you can donate skins and get GG back as well. And then it comes down to the highest bidder. And wow, are we about to be it? We just bet on the M4A4 Asimov. Time left, 2 seconds. Oh, and the time gets reset. So you got to stay on top of your bets right there. As we're trying to get in, there's you see this is some heavy competition for the M4A4 Asimov right now. And maybe we can get it. It might go to Quezzo. Wow, there's a lot of bidders for this. But this is, at least we're getting a live real-time example of how it works. Once the timer goes down, then everybody gets their chance. You want to get your bet in right as that timer is ticking down and hopefully be the last one. Otherwise, if somebody else bets, then it gets reset and another 10 seconds is applied. So maybe the timing of your bets can be beneficial as well. Maybe come on at like 4 a.m. or something like that. But it's very it's very interesting because all you have to do, you could potentially get this M4A4. Say you're the one of five people that are betting. You can get insane deals, like up to 99% off. A lot of it comes down to just the luck of the draw, just timing of it and everything. But if you stay on top of the bets, well, presumably you can make a massive profit with this website. Again, skinsanity.gg. Super cool. And you can even play rock, paper, scissors if you got that hot hand. I mean, I've won and lost a lot in rock, paper, scissors. I think, you know, I've hung up the gloves with that. But I think that'll be it. Again, skinsanity.gg. Now, did you want to say something? I've been just going in.
No. I think this is a great website. I mean, it's really easy. It's easy to understand. I mean, you can see everything on the front page. It's the interface is good. And guys, look, I mean, you get to save so much. You know, come in here, get lucky, try to bet. Make some, you know, make these bids work. You know, take these skins home and do more.
Yeah, cause, I mean, somebody's got to win. And if you get into one of those, whoever uses eBay, you know, there's some bidding wars and everything like that. But 9 p.m. here, you see there's a couple different ones up too right now that a couple people are unwilling. But again, look at the price. I mean, $207 currently. So even though there's a couple people going at it for this M4A4 Asimov, somebody likely to walk away with a hell of a deal, depending on how high it gets. Skinsanity.gg, check it out if you haven't, and we'll be right back for map number two.
You more than you know.